Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through the next topic, that is fixed time signals and vehicle actuated signals. Okay, so basically we can divide the time of the signals based on two parameters, guys. So one is a fixed time. So basically here the time is completely fixed and it will give that respect only. So it will not check the consideration of traffic or anything. It will directly give based on that particular timings. So if you say if there are only three lanes, okay, so I drawn. Okay, so in this way, so basically here the traffic, assume this lane and this lane and this line. So this line is given 30 seconds and this line is given 30 seconds and this line is given 45 seconds. So whatever might be the traffic status, each of these lanes will be given that respective time. That's it. There is no other word also, right? Yes. Vehicle actuated time is a bit different. Okay. Okay. We'll be discussing about that now. Okay. Yes. So fixed time signals are those in which green period cycle length are predetermined and for a fixed duration. So basically that green signal is of a fixed time, as I told you, right? So 30 seconds and 45 seconds in that way. Okay, whereas a vehicle actuated signals are those in which the green periods, okay, so the green light period vary and it is related to the actual demand of the traffic. This is possible by installing detectors on the approach. All the approaches, okay? Yes. So basically, instead of using this automated timing, we will be initializing some sensors which will check the status of the traffic, guys. Okay? So if you want me to draw a diagram, just give me a second. Okay, I'll be drawing on this PPT pages. Okay? So just here, observe, guys. Okay? Just give me a second, I'll be folding the paper. Okay. So basically here, the lanes will be having some sensors. Assume that it is an image processing application. So it will be checking whether the traffic is there or not. Okay, so here we are having three different sensors. So one sensor that side and one sensor this side and one sensor this side. So basically these sensors will sense that particular roads, guys. Okay, so this sensor will sense this road. It will be checking, okay, there are only 19 vehicles in total. This sensor will be saying there are 27. This sensor is saying there are 50 vehicles. So indirectly here we are forced to give this time, right? So here instead of 30 seconds, you'll be giving 45 seconds now. Okay, so once this is done, this came to 7 and you stopped. And now you notice that this 27 is more. So here you gave 25 seconds. Okay, so now this also came to 10, assuming that way. You stopped. Again for this you gave. So in this way, based on this particular traffic intensity, if you are giving those signals, that is nothing but the vehicle actuated signal. So that is the reason why vehicle word has come here. Okay, so now let us go through the advantages and disadvantages of each of them. Okay, so the fixed time are simple to construct, relatively inexpensive. So there are no need of any sensors or anything. Okay, so it is inexpensive, simple to construct, most successfully used in linked systems, requires a fixed cycle length for a given time or pattern at the speed. So basically most of the situations, this is better approach, guys. Okay, and the major disadvantage is it is inflexible, hence may cause avoidance delay. So assume that on this lane there are no vehicles, but you are wasting 45 seconds with that particular lane, giving a chance for them to go where there are no one, right? So it is just a waste of time. Okay, so requires a careful setting. So basically this setting up a time is really a complex thing in fixed time, guys, because no one can judge, right? So that is the reason why this is always a huge issue with the fixed time. Similarly, vehicle actuated signal. So here the major advantage is it is 100% flexible, as it adjusts basis based on the traffic condition. Okay, it delays to vehicle is a minimum and maximum capacity of achievement. Okay, and the major disadvantage is it is a bit costly, guys. So we might be saying that, okay, so a single four cameras will be enough, right? Yes, but these are four cameras for a single junction, guys. So how many junctions will be there in your city or in your country, right? There will be many. So establishing that many with machine learning or something should be used, right? So to identify those vehicles, to recognize them, to count them, to all those things, that is really a costly thing to do. okay, and cannot provide a signal coordination. So basically assume that this lane is continuously there are vehicles are coming, so then you are not going to stop, you are giving them only chance. These two will wait like that, so there is some coordination issues will be there, okay? Yes, so I hope everyone got some basic idea on this. So in the next lecture we will be discussing about the factors affecting signal design. So what are the different factors we will be considering in the next lecture, guys? Okay, yes, so let us meet in the next lecture. Thank you, thanks for watching.